Hey guys, welcome to your YouTube channel where we talk all about GATE. We are studying DBMS and we have started normalization, have covered a few of the normal forms, the first normal form, the second normal form, and here we are to understand the next one, which is the third normal form. Okay, so the third normal form, let me just define it. A relation is said to be in third normal form if and only if. Exactly like second normal form, it also has to satisfy two conditions. The very first condition is it is in second NF. Okay, so it has to be the relation for which we want that it should, whether it is in third normal form or not. First of all, that relation should be already in second normal form. Second condition, it has no transitive dependency. One more term is coming up here. We had discussed in second normal form that it should be already in one NF, that is first normal form, and it should not have any partial dependency. Okay, now go on to a next level. It has to be in second normal form. That means if I just decompose this part, or I just explain it further, then it says it should be in 1NF, because that was the condition for 2NF, it should be in 1NF, plus there should be no partial dependency, right? This is the meaning of it. So now including this along with no partial, no transitive dependency. Now these two taken together becomes the condition for third normal form. Okay? So theoretically, I mean, as in, if you have to define it formally, you would define it something like this. But now here question arises, what is transitive dependency, right? Yes. So we have seen normal functional dependencies. We never bothered that who is a determinant and who is a dependent. We just bothered there has to be set of attributes determining to the set of attributes determined. Okay, now in the previous session we also understood a particular type of functional dependency where the determinant was the part of candidate key and dependent was a non-key attribute. That was partial dependency. Now let's quickly reach and try to understand. So now see what is transitive dependency. Before getting into a formal definition of it, or let me just take one very small example. So let's assume we have a relation R which have, like, suppose A, B, C, D, E. These are the attributes present in this relation. And the functional dependency given for this relation is A, B determines C, C determines D, E. Okay? This is the functional dependency set given. So let's find out the key for this relation. So let's take up AB plus gives you AB, C, C gives you D and E. Any other? AB is not coming up anywhere else, and nothing else is possible. So this is only key, and what becomes the prime attributes or the key attributes? A and B becomes a prime attribute, and these three, C, D, E, these three becomes a non-prime attribute. Here are the prime attributes and here are the non-prime attributes. Now, if you just look into this dependency, you can see one thing very easily, which we had understood in inference rules or in the Armstrong axioms, which was transitive dependency or transitivity rule. What was the transitivity rule? The rule was if X determines Y and Y determines Z, then with the help of rule, you can say that X determines Z. It's a transitively dependency. It will get dependent with transitivity on X also. Right? Right. Now you see here what is happening here and how this nature is causing a trouble for us. I mean, why it should not have transitive dependency? Because it will cause some sort of redundancy, certainly. And to reach to the higher level of normal form or to become less redundant database, we have to ensure that this kind of dependency is not present, right? For that matter, now just see one thing. This is a key here, and C is a non-key attribute which is dependent on a key. Okay, so that is fine. Anything and everything, in fact, we should say should be dependent only on the key, right? But this non-key attribute is taking a power here and saying I can determine the value of other non-key attributes. Okay? So no matter I am dependent on something, but I myself have a power to determine the value of other non-key attributes. So in the relation, when you draw the instance for this relation, I'm not doing it because I want you to do that exercise. Sit with your pen and paper and try to make an instance for this relation with these functional dependency. Put some values in each and record, making sure you satisfy the given functional dependencies, and then check whether C determining D, E, or I could say this one like this also, that C is determining D and C is determining E, right? One and the same thing. So whether this dependency is producing more number of redundant data or not, certainly it will, because this way, whenever this value gets repeated, this is dependent on this value, that is true. But whenever this value gets repeated, the value of C, you have to repeat the value of D and E also. Okay, so that is not a very easily seekable or easily noticeable redundancy, but that is a redundancy which could be definitely ruled out if we follow no transitive dependency rule. So now let me formally define you what is transitive dependency. Let's have a dependency X determines A. This dependency is transitive dependency if any of the following can be drawn. Okay, so I have taken two cases, and it's like a small Venn diagram set of style to explain you. So the very first case says that the determinant is dependent on key, but the determinant can determine the value of A. Here this is key, this is non-key attribute, X is non-key attribute, and A is also non-key attribute. So that means this can determine the value of this, and the transitivity will happen like this. I mean, that key would be able to determine the value of A, but not directly. It will be determining the value of A through X. Okay, so this intermediate redundancy is present. No matter, key can determine the value of A, but this intermediate redundancy is still present. So that is why this is a transitive dependency. And how we can define it once again? Non-key attribute determining the value of non-key attribute. So whenever you see a dependency in this particular form, that non-key attribute determines the value of non-key attribute, that means it is a transitive dependency, and this is the case number one. Okay, now let's see the case number two. Case two says that key and X have some sort of intersection. Okay, definitely X is dependent on your key, but the X, which is a non-key attribute, this is getting combined with some key attributes, not the entire key, but some key attributes. So non-key attribute along with some key attribute, which could be single or more, okay, but it's not key completely. Make it very sure in your mind and in your notes that non-key attribute along with key attribute but not key completely is determining the value of A. A is again what? A is again non-key attribute. So the transitivity is present like this, that key is still determining the value of X. You remember the pseudo-transitive rule? Exactly. This is what happened here. This is a pseudo-transitive rule and this is a transitive rule. So here this is determining the value of A, but still again a level of redundancy is present because these two are also dependent. Okay, that's why we have to rule out any such type of dependency. And how I can define it further? Non-key attribute plus key attribute determine the value of non-key attribute. So you have got two formats. One is non-key to non-key. The other is non-key plus key attribute to non-key. Again, it might be a repetition again and again, but I would still emphasize that this is only the key attribute, not the key. If this would have been key, it would have become a super key. And having a super key at the LHS, at the place of determinant, is always an advantage, is never a problem. Okay, so this is certainly not the key, just the key attribute. So for third normal form, if you find a dependency, functional dependency of any of these two nature in your functional dependency set, then you say this relation is not in 3NF because it has transitive dependency. Okay, now let's solve some questions which will make us understand more about the third normal form. So I have taken two relation schemas with their functional dependency. The goal is just to find out the highest normal form of this relation. It's certainly in 1NF because it's coming up with a relation schema format. And now for checking further, the first thing is find out the key of the relation. So let's find out the key. And for that, in order to do that, let's compute the closure of AB, which gives me ABC. I had told you I always start with the very first determinant of the first dependency. That's my style of doing it. So it always goes on that way only. A, B, C, and C determines D, so it becomes D also. Now, out of the, this has showed that yes, it is A, B, C, D, so this is certainly super key. And the key it looks like, because A plus gives me nothing but A only. B plus gives me nothing but then the B only. So this is not further decomposable into any proper key. And next, after doing this, we have to check any of the part of it are available somewhere else. So I can also check for BC plus. BC plus gives me nothing because A is coming only from this place. So this is the only key. So the key is AB. Okay, so key attributes become AB and non-key attributes becomes C and D. Now look for the dependency one by one. AB to C, because key is determining a non-key attribute, so this is certainly not a problem of any type. Next, check for the next one. B and C. This is my key attribute. This is my non-key attribute. And this is also my non-key attribute. You just have seen in the previous view of this board that this sort of dependency is nothing but then transitive dependency. A key attribute along with non-key attribute determining the non-key attribute. So this is nothing but then transitive dependency. If transitive dependency is present, relation is certainly not in 3NF. So this is not in 3NF. It is in 1NF. And now let's check for the next one also. C to D. Non-key determining non-key. Again, what it is? It is transitive dependency. Because only transitive dependency is present. This was an absolutely good dependency. There is no partial dependency. The relation is in 2NF. Okay? This is how we are actually supposed to solve questions quickly in exam also. Whenever the relation is given, quickly find out the key. With the help of key, determine the type of dependency in the FD set, and based on that, declare your highest normal form. So now let's check for this second question, the next question. For this relation, let's quickly find out the key first of all. So what is the key? Again, the same style, AB plus. Let's check what AB plus is. A, B, C. Okay, all the three attributes. Fine. Now, breakable A plus, nothing, only A. B plus, nothing, only B. But here, A can be replaced by C. So this becomes BC, and BC plus gives you again ABC. Okay? Anything else possible? Not at all. So what becomes a key? There are two keys. We have two keys. One is AB, the other is BC. That means all the three attributes are key attributes. There is no non-key attribute. Generally, you would say that when you have every attribute as a key attribute, there is no possibility of any type of transitive dependency. The relation mostly and always be in the third normal form. So this type of functional dependency, key determining key attribute, absolutely fine. Okay? Key attribute determining the key attribute is, I won't say this is absolutely fine. I would say not known yet. This type of functional dependency we have not discovered yet. That what is it known as? And is it a problem or not? Will be definitely covered in the next video when we go up to the BCNF level. So far till the level of third normal form, this is not at all a problem. This is not at all a problem. And we say this relation is in all the three types of normal forms. Okay? All the three types of normal forms. The highest normal form for this relation is 3NF. Okay? I hope this is very clear to you. That what is 3NF, how do we check for the transitive dependency, what is transitive dependency, and you can also make use of what you have learned before in 2NF discussion. So all the things you can apply together in one question, how to solve the question. So quickly in the next video, I'm going to see you with the BCNF, and I want to again come up because I want to solve so many previous year old gate questions. All asked about the normal form. So let's finish up maybe BCNF in the next video, and then we'll take up the questions more detail, in more detailed way. So bye bye.